I'm Ashwini Vedakan. Joining us on this week's episode is BeWaxed founder Durga Kenny. But before we get into the show, here's a little sneak peek into her life. Welcome to the show, Durga. It's good to have you here with us.
Thank you so much. I'm excited to be here.
We're excited to have you. You look fabulous.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now, Durga, not a lot of people know this, but once upon a time, you were a model that walked fashion's ramps. Do you mind sharing a little background into your days working in the industry?
Gosh, it was years ago. However, actually, I started at the age of six. I did a little fashion show for a clothing company, and we walked the ramps at one of the hotels. That was the start.
Okay.
And then I did some modeling till I was about 22. Okay. It was a lot of print and media, a few ramp shows. But it was an exciting couple of years.
This is quite young. Did you feel like the pressure in the industry at that point?
A little bit, but I mean, it was all for fun actually when it started at 6, but I think around 8 to 10, I started getting lots of call-ins for media ads,
okay.
Right? Like for commercials.
Okay.
So then I started to enjoy it. I loved dressing up and the makeup and so it carried on till I was about 22.
Yeah. Wow. Now, do you see a difference in the industry from when you were in it and now? Do you find a difference in it?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, I think that like before, what I did find is they would look for pretty faces, right? Like at the time. But now I feel that it's more professional. They have requirements, you know, before they take you on. I also feel that now I'm so happy because they're taking different shapes and sizes. I can start to see that now in the industry here. I think internationally it started many years ago, but now here in Sri Lanka I can see that. And I'm so happy because it was something that was really lacking within the models that they were using here. And I also see that they're proudly using South Asian skin tones now, which is also wonderful because it really needs to connect with the audience. The moment you put out unrealistic body types, I feel like it puts a lot of pressure on the people looking, on girls looking.
There's an expectation from them.
Absolutely, yeah. But this way now, seeing these changes really makes me happy because it's giving every body type hope and being able to see that they're using such models.
Nice. Now let's talk about BeWaxed, right? How did it come to be? How did the brand begin? Can you share your story?
Wow, so we started in 2013 what I realized was, because I was doing waxing at the time, meaning going and having it done, and what I realized was it didn't have enough prominence.
Okay,
as a service, because yes, salons did offer it, but it was a sort of a side service, right?
Yeah.
So what we realized was, let's take this service and give it a more professionalism to it, right? Give it more attention. And
okay.
That's what we did. We opened our first outlet in Narvala, and it was a one-room.
The studio.
Yeah, a one-room little space, and we just grew from there. I have to say that I'm super passionate about waxing. I mean, I absolutely love it. So that is my reason for, you know, constantly trying to find new ways to up the game, studying and training internationally. I train internationally on and off so that I could absorb better techniques and bring it here and train my staff to use those techniques. I also feel like we removed the so-called taboo behind waxing, because when people talk about intimate waxing, it was very hush-hush. But I feel like we said, look, it's okay to come get an intimate wax. There's nothing wrong with it. There's nothing to be shy about. I think that was the reason that we've come this far, because we've given it a brand almost, I would like to say. Waxing itself now, if you look around in Sri Lanka, many people are screaming about waxing now. And yeah. I don't think a couple of years ago they were. It was a very hush-hush service.
Yeah. Okay. Now, when it comes to building a brand, we have to find ways to get the name out there. I feel like social media has definitely done that in the past, especially in recent times. So when you look at social media, brand building, how does it help businesses, especially ones that, such as yours?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, it's really helped me grow. I think initially, though, when we did open the salon, social media was just kind of, you know, coming into play, right? So it was a lot of word of mouth. And I think before, when salons did were able to expand or, you know, they depended on word of mouth. But now, actually, social media helps you to reach out to people in different areas and different backgrounds, and you can inform them through social media is what I feel. And a huge part of our business is because of social media. Absolutely, yeah.
Now, from humble beginnings in a one studio in Navala,
yes,
to now making it to the Maldives you mentioned before we got on cam. So, do you see expansion happening again?
Absolutely. I mean, sadly, because of COVID striking, but otherwise we would have opened our Indian outlet about a year ago. The plans were on its way to open last April. However, now we're back on track and we hope to open in January 2022.
Okay.
And that will be our first outlet in Bangalore. And then we hope to move on to Bombay and Delhi, Delhi being my hometown, so I'm really excited to get there. But yes, absolutely, we're looking at India, and I think it's going to be a good one going into the Indian market.
Well, wow. This is an inspiring story as well. Now that we've got the burning question segment out, we have a little game planned.
Okay.
It also, in a way, shows our viewers a little bit more about you.
Okay.
Okay. So we have a game called 20 questions.
Okay.
You have to answer rapid fire style.
Okay.
Don't be scared.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I am.
All right. Okay. First question. What is the weirdest dream you've ever had?
Oh my God. The weirdest dream. I don't know. I dream of driving different vehicles sometimes, and then I'm jumping out like a stuntman. I feel like I'm in a movie. I have weird dreams like that on and off.
Okay. What's your favorite movie to watch over and over again?
Dirty Dancing. Oh my God.
Patrick Swayze.
Oh my God.
Nobody put baby in the corner.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Your celebrity crush?
Oh my God. Do I really have one?
I think everybody does.
Kristen Stewart.
Oh. Kristen Stewart is the one from Twilight, right?
Yes.
As in Diana now?
Yeah.
Okay. Your biggest fear?
My biggest fear? Anything happening to my children. Yeah.
Okay. Wildest thing you've ever done?
I don't know if I could say this. wildest thing I've ever done. Gosh, actually, I don't know. I think I have a few more to do, so I can't really answer that. There are a few on the bucket list. I'll get back to you.
The best advice you've received?
Let it go. Things you can't control, things that are out, that you know that you just can't change, let it go.
Okay. Your idea of a perfect date?
I don't know. I guess my husband's done it many times. He wines and dines me. He surprises me. In our home, not even out.
Oh, okay.
Like he and my son sets up this little our little space with like, and our son serves me the wine and the food, and he's our little butler. It's really cute. I think that's my perfect date. Yeah.
Nice. Okay. Three things you look for in a partner.
Support. Okay, because that's really important, especially for me, because I'm constantly working and I need that support, right? Loyalty, of course.
Okay.
And being a good father, because I need that as well, because I work.
Your biggest turn off?
Arrogance.
Okay. What is the silliest pickup line or phrase someone has used on you?
You know, I've been partnered for 15 years, so I, for the life of me, can't remember.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, if you suddenly became a vampire, this is good because you like Kristen Stewart.
Yeah.
And have all the powers, okay? Who would you visit first?
Who would I visit first? Kristen Stewart.
Okay. Okay, if you could jump into a pool of something, what would it be without water?
Wine.
Nice. Okay, this is my favorite one.
Oh my God.
Okay. What word starts with F and ends with UCK? What's the word that starts with an F and ends with UCK?
Seriously, I don't know. I'm going to learn this one today.
Fire truck.
Oh my gosh.
Okay.
I'm going to try this on someone today. I'm going to do it on someone today.
What's the worst lie you've ever told?
No, nothing so far, but maybe I think I'm constantly lying, saying I'll be there in 2 minutes. That's like my everyday worst lie, because I'm never there in 2 minutes. Yeah.
And then what's your best lie?
Oh, this is amazing. You look beautiful. I love this food.
Ooh.
Yeah, so sometimes, okay, I might say that, but I genuinely don't mean it. Okay.
Clubbing or a candlelight dinner?
Oh God, I'm old now, so candlelight dinner.
Okay. A rant in social media or a letter of complaint?
A letter of complaint. I genuinely mean that, because I feel like it's a better way to approach that person, because ranting on social media leads to damaging a person's business.
Yeah.
And you know, if a business has like 30, 40 people and one person had messed up, I don't think everyone else should suffer the consequences for it. So I genuinely believe that a letter of complaint is the best way. Mm. And it's
also very intimate. It keeps it between the client.
Exactly. And you're able to resolve it. The moment you put it on social media, you have a million other people's opinions come into play. It kind of fuels it. And then both sides get defensive. So yeah, absolutely. Mm. Letter of complaint.
Are you impulsive or do you think first?
I do not think at all. I do not. Like, you know, I promise you, I wake up in the morning and I'm like, I need to do this. I want this. And I go into action. And by the next day, it's happening. That's how impulsive I am.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, the next one, our last one, this is actually a favorite of mine. And I kept it for the last
reason.
Okay. Because you said you love to wax. Okay. Have you ever messed up a client's waxing appointment?
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. I have no shame in saying it. I mean, we've been doing this for 9 years. We're not perfect. Absolutely. We've messed some appointments up, from be it to taking the appointment wrong or the wax type wrong, or, you know, and waxing is very sensitive. I have to say this, because some clients come in, they don't tell us if they're on medication or if they had their allergic, or if they've bleached their skin or gone out in the sun for days. Then those things obviously lead to issues with the wax.
You know? You had any funny stories you could share?
Some of my clients sleep during their intimate wax. I'm not obviously like mentioning names, but like intimate wax for me is...
After they do it?
No, during the session.
Oh, then how?
Yeah, exactly. I'm in awe. I'm in absolute awe that they can do that. That you can actually sleep during
it. Through that pain.
Through the pain, yeah. Because there is some discomfort. I mean, there's... I get this also all the time. Can you please suggest me a less painful or a pain-free wax? There is no pain-free wax. You are completely fooled if anyone tells you that. There is always discomfort.
I'm still trying to wrap my head around people sleeping with it. Like, how do you do that?
I'm in awe too.
Do you have to wake them up? Like, do you like?
Yeah, like when it's done, then the therapist will say, "Madam, we are finished." Yeah, yeah. It's amazing. But these are people that have been waxing for years. So,
it's,
your growth is finer. And yeah. Eventually you even have spots that don't grow out at all. So,
wow. Well, we reached the end of our segment. So thank you for joining
thank
us.
Thank you. I had so much fun. Thank
this
you for having
really
me.
Fun episode. And that's a wrap on another episode of Living Gets Real. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Instagram to catch the latest episode. Thank you for watching and stay safe.